Hi, today a quick look at the circuit boards from the Korg MS20 before I reinstall them, because yes, the capacitors test good and there is no need to replace them. It is quite a good news. So this is the main board with all the potentiometers. The first thing I did notice, so it is not easy to reach the holes in the potentiometer to spray the contact cleaners, and they are only attached with the connections, so it is really easy to bend them if you are not careful. And one other issue are these vertically mounted resistors. The legs have some isolating pins, but when they are bent, they can touch each other and it may create short circuits, so I am checking them before I reinstall. So, a close look for you over the wall PCB. These parts are quite weird. Look sure what they are. Precision resistors, maybe. No, they are called C, so they are capacitors. Audio grade capacitors. Maybe. So here you have the trimmers you can access from the holes in the front panel. And here is how look the connector sockets. Here we have one 7915 and one transistor on a heatsink. ICs here from a NEC on Motorola and op amps TL071. Regular stuff. These capacitors are a little bit moving. I will probably fix them with some hot glue before I install. On the back side, the solders are really clean. There is nothing to complain about the solders. And I even do not see anyone which needs reflowing. So it is good news. Not sure what is the goal of this big capacitor here, rated at 200 volts. Here you have heatsink coming all the way along. Big ground plane, and here the standoffs for the little Dover PCB, which I may show you and reinstall immediately. So this Dover PCB, more vertical mount resistors, lots of them. And nothing special. So I need to remember which way it was installed. The plug wants to come this way, so I guess this is the proper way to insert this. No. In fact, it was loose when I did get every item, so no way, you must install this like so. Maybe it is a question of moving the part in the correct direction. These standoffs, they are quite a pain. Yes, really a pain to reinstall this thing. But maybe it is why it did not remain in place, because they are prone to unhook themselves, these things. Not the best design, in fact. Look here, it is not making good effect to secure them. Okay, now we must be okay. So this is put back in place. We are good to go. Yes, it is quite not terrible. Okay, so this was the first PCB. Reinstall this immediately in a safe place. Next one. This little one. Again, here the potentiometers are only attached by the legs. So this one, it is not an issue because you have four channels, but on these ones, you can bend them quite easily. Apart from this, no issue. Here we have a plastic film capacitor, which is a radial mount, and they did bug it. Quite weird. The contacts are clean on these connectors, nothing to complain. Capacitors did test okay. I did unsolder one to test it. And I did reflow a few solders on this one. Not on the little one, but on the little one. Okay. So, last one, the Jax PCB. So as you can see, I did unbolt all the Jax, so I can remove this aluminum plate. Here you have a little PCB with a two LEDs attached on it. And here is what it looks like. We have some kind of a nice piece here. It is an optocoupler in this black cylinder with a LED and a photoresistor inside. A main volume potentiometer here, attached by wires. And apart from this, nothing special. So someone did notice the holes at the back of the PCB. And yes, surely enough, when you plug a jack in it, it will stick at the rear of the PCB. Interesting. Apart from this, nothing else to complain. I did clean the contacts inside, and in fact you can see which one were used a lot because the metal part here was bent a little bit too much, so I did unbent some of them. But I did get advice, there is one more here to correct a little bit, like just press a little bit with a screwdriver. I did use a Q-tip and contact cleaner to clean the contacts. They seem to be silver coated, but and they are quite darkened in fact. Here you have two difficult to reach connectors where you have to populate the wires before you install the PCB. And in fact it is all. The jacks did clean quite well, so I will reinstall this panel with the rusty bolts in order to keep shiny bolts for the outside. And also here, no issues with solder work. Nothing special to complain or to report. So I will, it is the first thing I will do on the way to the path, long path to reassembling it. Because in fact I do not see anything else to do on this device. It is quite cleaned as well as I could. The potentiometers have been cleaned, the capacitors are good, the solders are good, and it was working. So, I guess it is only now a matter of reassembly. So it was easier than expected, in fact. So, thanks for watching, bye bye.